Hello everyone, I just thought I'd make this video to try and show you guys some of the mods I've been doing to my setup, so we can have a look and see how much I've progressed since the last setup video I did. So you see I'm still running the quick release on there, but I've now got a VGA connector mounted in there, which is fully wired up to support the full electronics of the PCB, plus wired up on one of my wheel rims paddle shift connections that just connect, well, it's wired straight to the back of the original paddle shifters off this PCB. Also we've got, obviously I'm running it quite skeleton at the moment because of this big ass motor I got in there. It's that big. I had trouble just getting this side panel mounted on. If you can see from the back here, the motor's pushed right against the side panel, so I've actually had to pull the fan out of there and pull all the buttons out of here because they will not fit with this motor in, because it's only a single motor compared to the standard the twin configuration. It's very, very powerful, this motor. It's very similar to what you find in the T500. Except the circuitry on the Fanatic wheels obviously push their motors a lot harder than what all the other wheel manufacturers do. You can see I've got the wires coming through the shaft here, coming up to the PCB connection. I've actually got it spliced into a second so I can run dual PCBs off the one circuit board. I've also got a few wheel rims now. I've recently just got this one. I've had to modify up a little adapter there to suit my quick release connection. And if we flip that over there and have a look, I've got my VGA connector all wired up. And I'll show you just here, it's fully functional. Let's see if I can get this plugged in. Give me one sec. Alright, so we've got it plugged in and connected up. Just hit the on button there. I don't know if you can see the yeah, there we go. I put the white sticker over the dash display because I found my eyes getting quite confused over all the little markings you can actually see when the lights are lit up. But as you can see, I got the full functionality of the wheel rim. Just pull that one back off. Gotta be careful, I don't have a plate mounted up yet with the connector, so gotta be careful when I'm pulling the wheel rim off. And I'll show you my collection I've got of steering wheels, and yeah. So obviously I've got the new TX wheel to try with Forza 5, and I've been playing a bit of Forza Horizon 2 with it recently. It's quite fun, but that's a wheel rim with the DSD adapter for the T500. It also works on the TX. And these are the other wheel rims I've modified for my CSR Elite. So you can see I've got the VGA connector there, which is wired up to these. They're actually the same shifter modules as what's on all the Club Sport wheels. And I've mounted those up and got it all connected up. It's a really nice, I really like this wheel rim. And then this one here, I've actually modified from repaired parts I've just bought off the internet. The PCB, the CSR PCB, I had to wire all those little connections on there, but that as well. Fully wired up, so it's fully supported on my wheelbase. And I was thinking too, I'm probably going to add two buttons either side, just down here, like A, B, X, Y, because I've got those buttons under there. They're a bit hard to try and press with the steering wheel sort of on top. And this one, this is basically a wheel I've rebuilt out of all the spare parts that I've had. I've bought that many sort of odds and ends of broken wheels. I actually had enough parts to rebuild the whole wheel. And you can see this wheel rim is actually a CSR standard wheel rim. The Elite wheel rim is normally like a a flat black, this is the gloss, and this carbon fiber is actually just a sticker that I've put on there to cover the silver of the original CSR wheel. Makes it look a lot nicer. I'll be probably doing a few mods on this wheel and then selling it. One mod I'll be doing is adding this little slip ring. Basically what this does, instead of having the wire loom going through the axis of the thing and twisting all the wires, basically it'll just twist in this little mechanism here, so you have no issues with wires getting broken or anything like that. I also want to do another couple of mods on this too. I'm thinking this here is the original piece off the F1 steering wheel that I showed just before, and because that's got the connector there, I was thinking about making up an adapter to fit the bolt pattern of a normal steering wheel, so if I do sell it, people have an option of either having just the standard wheel rim, or they can put something else on there if they choose. Also trying to chase down a GT2 wheel, because I've got a couple of spare parts. I'll be able to get a GT2 wheel mounted up on this as well, because those wheel rims, their electronics work with the base, but the button configurations is a little bit backwards, but I still prefer to have options over wheel rims. As you can see, I've got a bit of a collection going. I still got my T500 base down there, which doesn't really get a lot of use. I'm not really a big fan of it. That's pretty much my setup. All my updates to my setup. Oh, one other thing I'll show too. This motor is also running on its own power supply. This power supply is actually a 27 volt 13 amp from memory. I've got it dialed back to about 25.5 volt because the motor is only supposed to be a 24 volt motor, but anyway. And also this little green wire here that actually comes down to this little air pump here, which actually pumps the air directly through the motor to try and keep it cool, because it generates quite a lot of heat. And I've also got my multimeter here, so I can test my temperature of the motor, make sure I'm not getting it too hot. And I've also added, if you can see here, this Velcro strip. I can actually take this off. And I normally have my phone on there with an app for all of my telemetry data and that sort of thing, so obviously I'm recording with my phone right now, but if you can pretend this was my phone, it'll just stick on there, and then when I have the wheel rim on there, it just gives me a nice view of all the rev indicator and shift lights and all that sort of thing. It's pretty nice, but yeah. Well, that's going to wrap up my video. Hope you guys enjoy watching, and thanks.